In this video, we're going over the history of orc racials, from when the game first launched in 2004, all the way up to present day in Shadowlands. First up, we have Axe Specialization. These came out at launch with the orc and made them the best race for horde warriors. And what it did was very simple, it gave you +5 to your axe and two-handed axe skills. You see, back in Vanilla WoW, we had weapon skills, where the more you used a certain type of weapon, the higher the chance you had to hit with that weapon type. And in Vanilla, these skills maxed out at 300, and some races were able to bring this higher than the maximum to 305. This meant that if you wanted to try to max out your hit cap, you needed 3% less hit chance from the rest of your gear thanks to the +5 in axe specialization. And it also reduced the amount of glancing blows you do, which increased your damage by a fair amount. And fun fact, kind of a side point, despite these things being much more important for physical damage dealing classes, the caster stat Intellect increases the speed at which you increased your weapon skills when you were training them for the first time. Next, we go over to Command. Command is fairly simple in comparison to Axe Specialization. It just increases the damage of the orc's pets by 5%. This made orcs a top choice for any class that heavily relied on their pets, like hunters and warlocks. Hardiness is the third orc racial, and arguably the best PvP racial that hordes have had access to, and maybe even the strongest PvP racial in the game even to this day. Besides, you know, there could be an argument made for another horde racial, Will of the Forsaken. But we'll go over that in a different video. So, what it did back in Vanilla was give the orc an additional 25% chance to resist a stun effect. This was insanely strong, and since Vanilla, it has been constantly nerfed. But even in its nerf state, it is still considered one of the best PvP racials. At launch, the ability was a little bit bugged, and a lot of abilities were just ignoring the racial. So in patch 1.5, they fixed it so that it would work properly. And last but not least, we have the most iconic of the orc racials, Blood Fury. The only active racial the orcs got, and what it did, was on a 2-minute cooldown, it increased your strength by 25%. And it dealt 5% of your maximum health as damage to you every 3 seconds. And the ability lasted for 20 seconds. This was later revised in patch 1.4 to increase your melee attack power by 25% for 15 seconds, where it would then decrease your attack power by 25% for 45 seconds afterwards. This allowed classes like rogues and shamans to benefit much more from it, since it no longer just increased strength. Finally, in patch 1.9, the hefty 25% melee attack power decrease was changed to be a 50% healing taken reduction instead. That way, it was a pure DPS boost and no longer had a DPS downside to it. Throughout Vanilla, it was really only used by warriors, rogues, and enhancement shamans, as it did nothing for casters or hunters that weren't stuck on Nightfall duty. Moving on to the Burning Crusade, pre-patch hardiness was nerfed down to 15% additional stun resistance, and I don't need to tell you again that this was still an S-tier racial. At the same time, Blood Fury was changed to give attack power for hunters, as well as spell damage for casters. And also, instead of being a flat 25%, it was a scaled value that increased with level. At level 1, it would give you 6 melee attack power and casters 5 spell damage, scaling up to 212 melee attack power and 143 spell damage at level 70. For hunters, it just gave attack power rather than melee attack power. And shamans actually got both the melee attack power and the spell damage. In patch 2.3, all of the weapon skill racials of all the various different races were changed from their +5 weapon skill to 1% crit for ranged weapons, and 1% expertise for the melee weapons. Much like hit chance in Vanilla WoW, you need a certain percentage to hit your expertise cap to maximize your chance to hit your targets and avoid the chance to hit with glancing blows. Basically, glancing blows are when your basic melee attacks just do less damage than they would normally. As for Command, it remained unchanged throughout this expansion. Moving on to Wrath of the Lich King, the healing reduction debuff from Blood Fury was removed, and at the same time, Hardiness was reworked, to make it so that instead of granting you 15% additional stun resistance, it just decreased the duration of stuns on you by 15%. Decreasing the duration of a stun is much less impactful than resisting the full stun altogether, but it's more consistent and doesn't rely on RNG, so it was still good after the change, and maybe just a bit less so. Also, in very early Wrath, Blood Fury was just taken off the global cooldown. Then in patch 3.1, with Blizzard remembering that the Death Knight class was added to the game, Command was extended to cover their pets as well as Shaman pets. And then in patch 3.2, Fist weapons were added into the weapons affected by Axe Specialization. So now orcs could get the expertise buff on Fist weapons too. In Cataclysm, the only racial change was in patch 4.3, where Blood Fury was changed again so that instead of spell damage for casters, it gave them spell power. As in Wrath of the Lich King, a lot of the items that had spell damage were just converted into spell power, making this racial one of the last spell damage holdouts. Cataclysm then removed spell power from armor, leaving it only to weapons, trinkets, and jewelry. In Mists of Pandaria pre-patch, monks were added to the game, and like shamans, they gained both the melee attack power and spell power buff from Blood Fury. Additionally, command was nerfed from 5% down to 2%. In Warlords of Draenor, Blizzard changed the number of stats in the game. This caused many of the racials to be changed as well to balance everything. Most of this came out with the pre-patch where expertise and hit stats were removed, heralding the death of Axe Specialization and all the other weapon specialization racials as well. Command was nerfed again, reduced from 2% damage increase to only 1%, where it has remained ever since. Hardiness, which had remained the same since Wrath of the Lich King, was nerfed from its 15% stun duration down to only 10%. This didn't last long though, as in the very next hotfix in patch 6.03, this change was reversed, bringing it back up to 15% it had always been for the past 3 expansions. Later on in patch 6.2.2, it was buffed even further to the 20% we now love today, once again firmly planting itself as the best all-around horde PvP racial in the game. Arguably, of course. In the Battle for Azeroth pre-patch, Blood Fury again was the last holdout, as Blizzard had removed the spell power stat early on in Legion, rolling its effect into Intellect. So in the BFA pre-patch, Blood Fury was brought in line with that, giving Intellect instead of spell power, as well as finally correcting the tooltip to attack power instead of melee attack power. And ever since then, there hasn't been any significant changes to any of the racials. Alright, and that's Orc Racials. If you have any ideas for future history videos just like this one, just leave them in a comment down below.